हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेंट जोसेफ इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल्स ग्रामर क्लास ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7th. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द फर्स्ट लेसन द सेंटेंस. सो लेट्स बिगिन इट विद द डेफिनेशन फर्स्ट. ओके, सो सेंटेंस. हैप्पी, very I am. Do these group of words make any sense? No, because they are not arranged in the definite order, so they are not the sentence. We arrange them to make the meaningful sentence. So I am very happy. So what is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words arranged in proper order to make complete sense. Okay, understand? And then next, read these sentences. We love our motherland. Walk fast to catch the train. Where is he? What a beautiful flower it is. So, do you notice anything? Yes, every sentence, each of these sentences beginning with the capital letter, each of these sentences begins with the capital letter W. Then each of these sentences has a verb like love, walk, is. And third one, each of these sentences ends with the full stop, question mark and exclamation mark. Now we can conclude that each sentence, every sentence must have a verb and it begins with the capital letter and ends with the full stop, question mark and exclamation mark. Okay, then next topic, parts of a sentence. Parts of a sentence. A sentence has two parts: subject and predicate. First, subject. Delhi is the capital of India. Second one, the pilot landed the plane in a field. And third one, shut the door. Here, what is the subject? The part of the names of the person or thing we are talking about is called the subject. We are talking about. Okay. So So here in the first sentence, we are talking about Delhi. So it is the subject. And the second sentence, the pilot landed the plane in a field. We are talking about the pilot. So the subject is the pilot. Okay. So the subject may be one word or more than one word. And third one, shut the door. It is an imperative sentence. Last year we have learned imperative sentence. The subject is, in imperative sentence, the subject is you. The subject is you. In imperative sentence, the subject is not mentioned, but it implies, that means understood. Okay. So in third sentence, you is the subject. Okay. And then predicate. Books are our best friends. Second, lions roar. So what is a predicate? The part which tells us something about the subject. Something about the subject is called the predicate. So here, are our best friends is the predicate, because it tells something about the subject, books. So books is the subject, and are our best friends is the predicate. So the predicate can be one word or more than one word. If the predicate is consists of one word, it is said to be verb. So here in this second example, the predicate is roar. It is consist of, the predicate consists only one word, so it is a verb. So roar is the predicate, and it tells about the subject lines. Okay. Then we know well, there are four kinds of sentences. Kinds of sentences. There are four kinds of sentences. First one, assertive or declarative. Sentence. Then second one, interrogative sentence. And third one, imperative sentence. And the fourth one, exclamatory sentence. First one, assertive or declarative sentence. Assertive or declarative sentence states something. It ends with the full stop. For example, these books are new. So this assertive sentence may be two. First one, positive sentence, and then second one, negative sentence. To make the negative sentence, we add not after the helping verb. So these books are not new. This is the negative sentence. Negative sentence. Next, interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentences ask questions and end with the question mark. So interrogative sentences has two types. There are two types. First one, WH question, and the second one, yes or no question. So if the sentence, that means if the question begins with the WH word, like why, when, where, what, then it is said to be the WH question. And second one, if the sentence, the question begins with yes or no, means a helping word, they are said to be yes or no questions, like do, did, does, is, am, are, was, where, has, have, heard, will, shall, should, would, can, may, might, like that. Okay, so the examples are question sentence, WH question sentence, where do you live? Where do you live? And yes or no question, the example of yes or no question, do you like me? Question mark. Okay, then third one, imperative sentence. We already learned in the class 6, imperative sentence has begin with present tense, that means shut the door. For example, shut the door. Here in this sentence, here the subject is not mentioned, but it is implies, that means understood. So you is the subject here. Okay, so then fourth one, exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentence expresses, exclamatory sentence expresses strong and sudden feeling. For example, hooray, we won the match. Here this sentence, feeling of joy. And the second, alas, she lost her bag. The sentence of sorrow, feeling of sorrow. And the third one, what a brilliant girl she is. It is surprise, feeling of surprise. So exclamatory sentences expresses strong and sudden feeling of joy, sorrow and surprise. The examples of joy is hooray, we won the match. You also write hooray, comma, we won the match, ending with exclamation mark. And also, alas, she lost her bag. You can write, alas, comma, she lost her bag, exclamation mark. So let's revise today's lesson. We learned what is a sentence and parts of a sentence, subject and predicate, and kinds of sentences, right? Four kinds of sentences, assertive or declarative sentence. Assertive or declarative sentences state something, it may be positive or negative. And then interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentences are two types. They are WH question and yes or no question. And third one, imperative sentence. It expresses, imperative sentences expresses commands, order, advice or make request. And then fourth one, exclamatory sentence expresses joy, sorrow and surprise. Okay, thank you.